and praise to the Lord. Shout to God, all you heavens, and clap your hands, you on earth. Enter into his presence, exulting and singing for joy. Praise to the Lord, praise and praise to the Lord. Praise to the Lord, praise and praise to the Lord. Know that God is our Father, he made us, we are his own. Come to him with thanksgiving, extolling and blessing his name. Praise to the Lord, praise and praise to the Lord. Praise to the Lord, praise and praise to the Lord.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
amen.
The Lord be with you. In preparation to celebrate this Eucharist, let us acknowledge our sins. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who to safeguard the Catholic faith and to restore all things in Christ, filled Pope Saint Pius X with heavenly wisdom and apostolic fortitude, graciously grant that, following his teaching and example, we may gain an eternal prize. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the prophet Ezekiel. The hand of the Lord was laid on me, and he carried me away by the Spirit of the Lord, and set me down in the middle of a valley full of bones. He made me walk up and down among them. There were vast quantities of these bones on the ground, the whole length of the valley, and they were quite dried up. He said to me, Son of man, can these bones live? I said, You know, Lord. He said, Prophesy over these bones. Say, Dry bones, hear the word of the Lord. The Lord says this to these bones, I am now going to make the breath enter you, and you will live. I shall put sinews on you. I shall make flesh grow on you. I shall cover you with skin and give you breath, and you will live, and you will learn that I am the Lord. I prophesied as I had been ordered. While I was prophesying, there was a noise, a sound of clattering, and the bones joined together. I looked and saw that they were covered with sinews. Flesh was growing on them, and skin was covering them. But there was no breath in them. He said to me, Prophesy to the breath. Prophesy, son of man. Say to the breath, The Lord says this, Come from the four winds, breath. Breathe on these dead. Let them live. I prophesied as he had ordered me, and the breath entered them. They came to life again and stood up on their feet, a great an immense army. Then he said, Son of man, these bones are the whole house of Israel. They keep saying, our bones are dried up, our hope has gone, we're as good as dead. So prophesy, say to them, the Lord says this, I am now going to open your graves, my people. I mean to raise you from your graves, my people, and lead you back to the soil of Israel. And you will know that I am the Lord when I open your graves and raise you from your graves, my people. And I shall put my spirit in you, and you will live. And I shall resettle you on your own soil, and you will know that I, the Lord, have said and done this. It is the Lord who speaks. The word of the Lord. Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his love has no end. Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, his love has no end. Let them say this, the Lord's redeemed, whom he redeemed from the hand of the foe, and gathered from far off lands, from east and west, north and south. Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his love has no end. Some wandered in the desert, in the wilderness, finding no way to a city they could dwell in. Hungry they were and thirsty, their soul was fainting within them. Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his love has no end. Then they cried to the Lord in their distress, and he rescued them from their distress. And he led them along the right way to reach a city they could dwell in. Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his love has no end. Let them thank the Lord for his love, for the wonders he does for men. For he satisfies the thirsty soul. He fills the hungry with good things. Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. For his love has no end.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Teach me your paths, O God. Make me walk in your truth.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Beloved, the Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. When the Pharisees heard that Jesus had silenced the Sadducees, they got together and, to disconcert him, one of them put a question, Master, which is the greatest commandment of the law? Jesus said, you must love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind. This is the greatest and the first commandment. The second resembles it. You must love your neighbor as yourself. On these two commandments hang the whole law and the prophets also. The good news, the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Can these dry bones live? Can they really live? Beloved in Christ, difficult and challenging circumstances of life can weigh us down, can wear us down as well, wound and bruise our spirit, and make us feel lifeless as these dry bones, and even hopeless. You know, beloved in Christ, sometimes we experience and encounter in our lives financial crises,
terminal illnesses in our families, struggling relationships, political fights. These circumstances often drain every ounce of physical and emotional energy from us. And of course, there are other times, beloved in Christ, that we feel this lifelessness, we feel this hopelessness in relating with other persons or other situations. It may be an addiction in our family, a family member who is addicted and struggling with an addiction. It may be a family member or friend who is experiencing mental illness. Or it may be the threat of hurricanes or floods. In the end, these circumstances of life leave us feeling like dry, lifeless bones. And we ask ourselves the question, can I really live again? Can this family member live again after going through such a devastating circumstances of life? Well, you know, beloved, if we listened attentively to the scripture readings this morning, Yahweh's response is found in the first reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. Yahweh says, I am going to make the breath enter you, and you will live. You will live. In the book of the prophet Ezekiel, we see that as a nation, the people of Judah felt lifeless. They felt homeless. They were in exile. They felt like dry bones in exile. No homeland, no temple to worship, no worship at all in their temple, no independence. Their lives felt controlled not by Yahweh, but controlled by a pagan nation. And so in the midst of this devastating, dry bone-like circumstances of the exile, Ezekiel receives a vision in which Yahweh transports him to this valley, this enormous valley filled with dry bones, lifeless dry bones. And as Ezekiel goes through this valley, the question that Yahweh asks is, can these dry bones live again? And in response, Yahweh says, yes, they can live, because I will breathe my spirit in these dry bones. The very spirit, Ruah, that Yahweh breathed into the earth and formed man and woman, as is recorded in the first creation story, in the second creation story of Genesis, that same breath, that same spirit, Yahweh told Ezekiel, I will breathe life into these dry bones, and these dry bones will live again. And so, beloved in Christ, the missionary challenge that faces us as we listen to these scripture readings, these very powerful and profound scripture readings, is simply, don't give up either on yourself or on others whose life appears hopeless, whose life appears lifeless and done for. Do not give up. No matter how daunting and discouraging your situation or the situation of others appear, love is the spirit that can breathe new life into any dry bone-like situation. The act of love, given or received, refocuses us from hopelessness and makes us experience the power of being embraced and being accepted in our dry bone type situation. A simple act of love has the power, beloved in Christ, to renew someone, A simple act of love has the power to revitalize someone. A simple act of love has the power to rejuvenate, to re-energize anyone. Just imagine a situation, for example, where a child, a baby, has fallen on the ground and begins to cry. And the moment the hand of the mother or the father reaches down and picks that child up and holds that child close to their chest, the moment that happens, what happens? The child, the baby, stops crying. A simple act of love has the power to transform any dry bone-like situation. It is for this very reason that very song that we often sing, love, love changes everything, is so powerful and so true. And I'm particularly drawn to the second stanza of that song that says, love, love changes anything. Days are longer. Words mean more. Pain is deeper than before. Love will turn your world around, and the world will last forever. Yes, yes, love changes everything. It brings you glory, brings you shame. Nothing in this world will ever be the same.
Love changes everything. Days are longer, words mean more. Love changes everything. Pain is deeper than before. Love will turn your world around, and that world will last forever. Yes, love changes everything. Brings you glory, brings you shame. Nothing in the world will ever be the same. Nothing in the world will ever be the same.
So, beloved, if today you are asking the question, can these dry bones live? Yahweh says to us and to you, yes, I will breathe the spirit of love in you. And when you experience that spirit of love, go and breathe the spirit of love in the dry bones of other people's lives. Amen. And so, beloved in Christ, let us offer our petitions, knowing that there's so many persons in the world among us who are experiencing dry bone-like situation. And so we offer these petitions for them. We pray in a particular way for Holy Father Francis, for all the bishops throughout the world who collaborate with him in the ministry of teaching, governing, and sanctifying the church. We pray for a new outpouring of the Holy Spirit upon them, that they may be re-energized, renewed, and revitalized to continue leading and pastoring the people of God with courage and boldness. Lord, hear us. And we pray in particular for healing for Rhonda Mansoom, that as she goes through her difficult and challenging and dry bone-like situation of illness, that
the Spirit of God may truly come upon her and renew her and bring healing. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
In thanksgiving for Melina Brathwaite and family, and also for the intentions of Denise Monzano, that truly God may hear and know the depths of their heart and truly answer their prayers. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for the wedding anniversary of Conrad and Leigh Marie's, that in, as they celebrate their wedding anniversary, truly God may renew their commitment, renew them, revitalize them, and so that they may recommit their lives to this sacrament. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
And in thanksgiving for the birthday of Bernadette Mackays, Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for those who have died, gone before us, marked with the sign of faith. We pray especially for Della Marie Walcott, for Peter Ristick, and Shane McNeil. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Lord, you have listened attentively to these our petitions. Truly grant them to us through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Breathe on me, breath of God. Fill me with life anew, that I may love what thou dost love, and do what thou wouldst do. Breathe on me, breath of God, until my heart is pure, until I have one will to live and to endure. Breathe on me, breath of God, till I am wholly thine. Until this earthly part of me glows with thy fire divine.
Pray, beloved, that my sacrifice and yours may become acceptable to God and the Almighty Father. Receive with kindness our oblations and grant, we pray, that following the teachings of Pope Saint Pius, we may celebrate these divine mysteries with sincere reverence and receive them in a spirit of faith through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For in the marvelous confession of your saints, you make your church fruitful with strength ever new, and offer us sure signs of your love, and that your saving mysteries may be fulfilled. Their great example lends us courage, their fervent prayers sustain us in all we do. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, as in exaltation we acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord. Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is a chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Charles Jason, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all your saints, especially Saint Pius X, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other a sign of Christ's peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Brothers and sisters, at this time, those right here in the chapel will receive Jesus sacramentally in Holy Communion. You're invited to join us and make your own spiritual communion, to join your hearts with us, those of you who may be alone at home, or those of you who may be going through some kind of struggle in your life. Whatever it is, the Lord comes to you right now. He pours his healing love upon you, and he beckons to you. Enter into this time and allow the Lord to minister to you his healing love. And as we pray, join me in prayer. My Jesus, I believe you are in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I long for you in my soul. Since I now cannot receive you sacramentally, come spiritually into my heart. As though you have already come, I embrace you, Lord, and I unite myself entirely to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. O Divine Savior, O Jesus, O Blessed Sacrament.
Gentle as silence. Every day, every hour, every moment, have been blessed by the strength of his love. The turn of each time, he is there at my side, and his touch is as gentle as silence. We offer
particularly this moment for those who have joined us spiritually, experiencing the spiritual communion, those who have joined us through the media and are not able to physically celebrate the Eucharist with us. You have heard God's word. God's word have touched you gently. And you may be going through a dry bone situation currently, or you may know someone who is going through a dry bone situation, a friend, a family member. Let us remember the readings, remind us, particularly the gospel reading. An act of love has the power to transform and to breathe new life into us and to the lives of others. So I pray that you may have the grace and the strength today, as we begin this new day, that through the act of love, you may breathe the spirit of love and into life into others. Believe that it has power.
When I've turned from his presence, and I've walked other paths or the way, but I've called on his name in the dark.
Let us pray. Celebrating the memorial of Pope Saint Pius, we pray, O Lord our God, that by the power of this heavenly table, we may be made constant in the faith and be one of one accord in your love. through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the good news by your lives and acts of love.
Thanks be to God.
Lift high the banners of love, alleluia. Sound the trumpets of war. Christ has gotten us a victory, alleluia. Jericho must fall. The body of Christ is an army, fighting powers unseen, bringing the captives to freedom in the name of Jesus our King. Lift high the banners of love, alleluia. Sound the trumpets of war. Christ has gotten us a victory, alleluia. Jericho must fall. Brothers, are you sure of your calling? Will you fight for Jesus the King? Are you prepared in this battle to lay down your lives for your friend? Lift high the banners of love, alleluia. Sound the trumpets of war. Christ has gotten us a victory, alleluia.